music fades, all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth, that will bless your heart. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not.
Worship to me is anything that can bring you closer to God, and I think, I mean, music is one of the best ways to do that, as far as I'm concerned, just because it comes from the soul, it comes from the heart, it brings you as close as you can be.
Is going to be different for a lot of people, but the same thing that it is for everyone is, it's how do you communicate with God?
I think worship is a little bit different for everybody, and music is a way to help people express what the love that they feel in their hearts for Christ, and just makes it a more enjoyable experience for everybody.
I think it's important for us to express things to God through music, and that we can praise, and that we can mourn, that we can give thanks, that we can stand in awe of who He is and what God does, and express that through music.
We come before the Lord and in a new way become aware of the Lord. I mean, the Lord is always around us all the time, but often we are not aware of how God is working in our lives. We're just in the everyday rut. And worship is when we stop, we slow down, we listen. The Spirit of God becomes accessible to us. And when we do that, we praise, we rejoice, we sing hallelujah. We come to God with all of our loves and our joys and our concerns and our pains. And we find that we're fed and sustained through what God gives us, through Scripture, through the way our songs sing, the prayers of our hearts. So to me, worship is an experience of meeting the living God that we love, and we rejoice and we worship in a time of praise.
To me, music is that part that unifies everybody. Music is what brings everyone into the right mood in the beginning, and it inspires people. And I just, music is what, when I was a young kid, got me going to church. Music is what kept me going to church, and now I'm just really enjoying being a part of it, and maybe keeping some other people in the same spirit.
I mean, that I think that it's special that we can do that in any way, whether it's playing in a praise band or if it's a classical aria, that we can still make praise and make beautiful sounds to the Lord.
The stories in the Psalms are all stories of God's people singing. And so in the Psalms, we find songs of joy, songs of sorrow, songs of celebration, songs of anguish. David, the psalmist, was really present with God. And in that, he used both words and music. Unfortunately, in the Psalms, we only have the words. We have to guess at the music, but I think that makes it fresh and new, because we're constantly reimagining it and letting it speak fresh and new in different situations. But it isn't just in the Psalms. The oldest known part of the Bible, as I've been told, is something called the Song of Miriam, a song of rejoicing when the people of Israel went through the bottom of the Red Sea with the waters all around them. And when the people were freed from that bondage, the first thing they did was celebrate in song. And Paul speaks to us in the New Testament that we should be constantly about praising and singing to our Lord and our God. Even in the book of Philippians, he brings an extract that we understand is part of the Psalms of the ancient church when he talks about Jesus Christ. And so I sense that you couldn't worship without singing. Singing is so deeply embedded in what it means to be God's people that it wouldn't be true to who we are and who God is if we didn't have music part of it. I'll bring you more than a song.
Thank you.